Testing. 1, 2, 3.
One
Thank you. I said I loved you without hesitation. So easy for you to break my foolish heart. Now I wonder if you ever speak my name. And I will always be defined by my mistake. In the eyes of a Savior, we're all trying.
Please be seated. Welcome to St. Saviour's Church. Thank you for coming. And thanks to all who have prepared the church for this service. Vicky was a member of our church community, a long-time member of our Flower Guild, and latterly its coordinator. And the flowers are fitting for her farewell. It does feel rather strange to still be kept so far from one another, especially on an occasion like this. But all the measures we've taken, the masks, the hand sanitizer, and the space seating, and the one-way system, are all to keep everyone as safe as possible. The only exception we're making to strict social distancing is for Vicky and her escort and the family, who enter and leave the church down the centre aisle. At the end of the service, everyone else please follow the one-way system, leaving through the two doors into the parish centre and then by the main parish centre door. Please maintain social distancing both inside and outside the church. Sadly, we are not allowed to sing. And it's so good that Matt and friends have been able to come and sing for us, as Vicky would have wanted. We meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace and mercy be with you. We have come here today to remember before God our sister Vicky, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit her body to be cremated, and to comfort one another in our grief. So let us pray. Almighty God, you judge us with infinite mercy and justice, and love everything that you have made. In your mercy, turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life, and the sorrow of parting into the joy of heaven, through our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. And now I'm going to ask Kathy to come and read our poem for us.
Thank you. Stop all the clocks. Cut off the telephone. Prevent the dog from barking with a juicy bone. Silence the pianos. And with muffled drum, bring out the coffin. Let the mourners come. Let aeroplanes circle moaning overhead, scribbling on the sky the message, she is dead. Put great bows round the white necks of the public doves. Let the traffic policemen wear black cotton gloves. She was my north, my south, my east and west, my working week and my Sunday rest. My noon, my midnight, my talk, my song. I thought that love would last forever. I was wrong. The stars are not wanted now. Put out every one. Pack up the moon. Dismantle the sun. Pour away the ocean and sweep up the wood. For nothing now can ever come to any good.
Thank you, Cathy. And Matt and friends are going to sing to us again. Hallelujah and rise up.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith, that all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So now I'm going to invite Liz to come and read our Bible reading for us.
I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children."
Thanks, Liz. Vicky, what to say about a life so full of loving and giving, as well you know. And for a short while, it was my privilege to know her too. Victoria, Anne without an E, Pagan, was born in St Catherine's Hospital in Birkenhead on the 5th of October 1962, the first and only child of Vera and Bob. The family moved to Heswell when Vicky was three, but then back to Nocturum when she was nine. Vicky was only the second cohort of children to attend the then brand new Ridgeway High School, where she passed her O-levels and A-levels to gain a place at Edge Hill to train as a teacher, specialising in singing and music. Vicky's love of music and singing continued to be expressed through her teaching, through her involvement with the Gang Show, and through her membership of Birkenhead Choral Society. While at uni, each summer Vicky would travel to the south of France to work at her dad's holiday park, gaining life experience and a lovely tan. She graduated in 1986, and her first job was at Eastway Primary School in Morton. Perhaps more significant that September, a friend, you know who you are, took Vicky to a scout meeting. And there followed a long life commitment to both scouting and Paul, but more of that later. Vicky taught in several local schools, all places where she felt that she could make a difference. Portland Primary School in Birkenhead, then on to Arrow Hill in Woodchurch, where not only was she the Senko, working with children with learning difficulties, but also working with the families of those who were simply not engaging with their children's education or school. Cole Street in Birkenhead until it closed, and then on to Liso. And everywhere she went, there was singing and music. And she always went the extra mile for those in need. And it won't surprise anyone to know that Vicky'd started training to be a counsellor in the last couple of years. Back to September 1986. From that first scouting meeting and onward, Vicky was involved with scouting, and her involvement for Vicky meant commitment. Working with all three sections of the 25th Birkenhead over 30 years. Local training manager for the young leaders training for the Birkenhead Explorers, deputy district commissioner, and throughout it all, ready to lend a helping hand and a listening ear. Then we come to the gang show. Vicky started in the makeup team 30 years ago, then took on more and more diverse roles as each one was needed. The business committee, the tuck shop team, organising smiler prizes, helping the production team, assisting the musical director, copying and compiling songbooks. The list goes on. And always with a ready smile and an infectious sense of humour. But then there was something else of real significance that first scout meeting in September 1986. Paul was there. Romance blossomed and they married in August 1988. Full lives with work and scouting, and because of Paul's shift work, holidays became particularly important. Time to adventure together. And so they did. In Thailand, in Egypt, in the Caribbean, among other places. But France remained a favourite and continued to do so when first Mia and then Rory came along, and Euro camping became the order of the day. Although other destinations did make an appearance, including a family trip to Disney in the US, each one holding treasured memories of time together. Vicky loved the outdoors. She loved walking, especially with Baxter. When their foreign holiday was cancelled last year because of the pandemic, she made most of the British countryside, Wirral, Mavama, the Lake District and Edinburgh, and even managed to fit in a 5K run for good measure. Vicky's diagnosis out of the blue was a bombshell. But she, despite her fears and her pain, handled it with grace and at the end found peace surrounded by the family. Vicky, the kind, loving, selfless person that we knew, has died. Vicky, until so recently, so full of life and laughter, who touched our lives, is dead, and we find it so hard to believe it, never mind to come to terms with it. The poem that Kathy read echoes in our ears. I thought that love would last forever. I was wrong. For nothing now can ever come to any good. Yes, that's what it feels like. We are all made in the image of God, to be in relationship, to love and be loved. So when a loved one dies, our whole life has changed forever, and our pain is so great that we feel as if the whole world should reflect that pain. Our Bible reading today was written to Christians who were hurting too. They were grieving, persecuted, imprisoned, or simply just being murdered for their faith. St. John's vision gave them hope that this earthly existence is not all that there is. For all of us in the last year, separation, sickness, and untimely deaths have become an everyday occurrence. We have hope in science and modern medicine that this will come to an end, but with or without a pandemic. We still live in a world where pain, suffering and death is just how it is. So what can this reading say to us? It tells us what God's kingdom is like. Not should be like, or even could be like. In God's good time, will be like. No more pain, no more death, no more mourning, no more crying. God will wipe away our tears. It says that God will once more be with all his people, ransomed, healed, restored, forgiven people, as companion and king. Everything will be made new, a new heaven, a new earth, and nothing to divide them from each other or from him. Of course, God is here now, as close to each one of us as we choose to allow him to be, ready to help, to heal and to lead us if we but turn and ask him, in words or sighs when words have fled. Vicky, in her own way, made that request and is now at home in the place Jesus prepared for her. For her, a new day dawns in his closer presence, and we are left with our memories to mourn. As we remember all the love and kindness that Vicky shared with us, let us also remember that God so loved the world that he gave his only Son Jesus to save us all, to open up for us the way to his kingdom. Yes, that kingdom that St. John was describing. And we still have the opportunity to explore that cause for hope, and to accept his invitation. Let us pray. God of mercy, Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Vicky, for the grace and mercy she received from you, for all that was good in her life, for the memories we treasure today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good this your servant Vicky, as we also remember her. Bring all who rest in Christ to the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on Paul, Mia and Rory, the wider family and all who mourn. Give them patient faith in times of darkness. Strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You are tender towards your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal the memories of hurt and failure which we bring to this service today. Give us the wisdom and grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth, to turn to Christ and follow in his steps, in the way that leads to everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of mercy, entrusting into your hands all that you have made, and rejoicing in our communion with all your faithful people, we make our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. Let us say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Please stand. Let us commend Vicky to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power, Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust Vicky to your mercy in the name of Jesus our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you, now and forever. Amen. Please sit or kneel to pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, in his infinite love and mercy, bring the whole church, living and departed in the Lord Jesus, to a joyful resurrection and the fulfillment of his eternal kingdom. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
I don't know why, Mr. said we've got you.